The time has come to properly build a proper import system that does everything. Because right now it's kind of split between these loose functions and this class just does the resources. I need something that does all of it together using these individual parts. So the first part that is going to have to be, well, the outside importer. So one thing I'm going to want to do is, I guess I'll just create like a just importer import. We'll just call it import state, something like that. And it's just going to be returning what it'll return a simulation set. Which I currently have. Okay, so actually, what I need to do is a simulation set. I need to grab that from the application. So that's not application specific. Thank you. Okay, we got those. Gonna need to grab a couple headers, editor name and groups. Resource pools and state pools. Okay. Put that together. That's defined. Yes, it is. So that's one thing we're going to be bringing in is if and def. We'll have, do we need a class? Maybe. Because what we're going to need is we need something that be able to generate the actual importers, the individual importers, such as YAML importer, the distributed this, which is going to need a base class that's shared amongst a couple other items. So we got public importer base. That. I mean, class, really. Virtual phone. Destructor, something like that. So distributed YAML, I need to import or include. That, okay. I need to make that public. And we need a standard vector of functions. So we need to include vector, we need to include functional that will return a faux importer base and takes in what? A file path? Oh, yeah, okay. We're taking a file system path. Close that up. It's annoying that importer generators. We need a struct or a class. That, and we need to include file system. Because what's going to happen is the, I don't know why I have it open in two, simulation set star import state. Struct that. But we start with the file we're opening, and we've selected a file or a directory, much like in anything else. We do know the starting point. Initial state path. Yes, just... And then we have the search paths for determining, for finding the sub, the dependency data. Like that. So class. And then we'll have a couple functions that bool and importer. Generator. Takes in this. Okay, let's get import state. These are the two functions we have for the moment. Close that. Okay. Can we actually do comparisons of standard functional objects? Operator equals checks if target is contained. Yes, no. It only compares it against the null pointers. We can't tell if the function we have is the same. So I can't prevent duplicates from being added. But what if it's just a plain old, what if it's just a plain old C-styled one, actually, P generator function, and it takes in that, right? That can work. And then we can do a remove as well. Okay, for auto iterator of importer generators, we go through if equals p generator function, then return false. Otherwise, we didn't find it, so we can add it. And similarly for removal. Just change out the void. We need to change it as well, so it's for auto iterator equals m importer dot begin. Go through iterator star iterator equals p generator function and importer dot erase the iterator we've got and then just leave. Or no, actually just go through all of them. Iterator equals, just in case it was added more than once, maybe? Something like that. Okay. Whatever. Okay, then we get back to, now that we got that. Now we go down to the actual state importation. So the first part will be, find the importer. Starting path, something like that. I think so. Yeah, okay. Auto. No, not auto star. It'll be faux importer base star p importer. Starts off as a null pointer. Go through the generators. We check if. Equals iterator of the path that we have, state data path. If it's not that, then we break out. If it's still null pointer, then we need to return. String for Windows. We return nothing. I need to add this to be GI while I'm here. Okay, now we need to get the want to get the list of dependencies. And we need to go through the importer. Okay. This means going to importer base. We have a function that's going to return string of a list of strings of virtual. What's actually going to happen is that this will be added to this just after that. It's an override. Find this. This is a very similar functionality to what we got in here somewhere. Import state dependencies from file. So not doing that, we're going to return a list of those. We need to return, we need like a return a boolean really. From file, and then, yeah. So we can copy these in. We do not have these here yet. We can shorten this down to be like that. Something like that. Really, we don't know what a string is. Okay, Clang just broke instead. Oh, code. Oh, no, there we go. Open it up. Let's do it again. Open recent. And we're back. YAML parsing. Exception. That's what we're throwing in. home file, which includes the mroot. You change this up to be like that. Similar, moving up to the importer base. Need the dependencies file path. Pass that through, okay. Let's come back out, import state. We got the list of dependencies. You want Control Shift B, build quick. Member access into incomplete type. Okay, so we've got the list of dependencies. Now we need to generate importers for all of the dependencies. Put it into sub function. Yeah. So what do we need out of this? We need the list of dependencies. The what? P search paths. The out function of dependency importers. And we need the vector of, let's see if we can. Hmm. And then we need this monstrosity. Something like this. Okay. And then we have to go through the list of finding them. So I need the auto path reader. Do I include search paths? Not yet. Get reader, I think. It's not complaining, so I'll take that as a yes. We need to go through for each dependency. Dependency iterator, or just dependencies. Cause it's a standard string, I'll just reference it. We need to go through each, path reader, it's local. Then we need to go through the iterator, through the directory, for auto dir iterator. Directory. It's not recursive, so we'll just go with. Of the path we have, which is search path, going through the current, which is the directory iterator dot path dot stem. JClang already broke, that's nice. If the stem equals the, what we're looking for specifically, the dependency iterator, which is a string, if the stem equals that, so the stem will be the same whether it's a file or a folder. So we found it. So actually, no, what we want is we want the path. So we're going to reuse that. We need to go through, we need a... That's a null pointer. If No, for auto iterator. New importers, importer generators. These are just function pointers, so it should be nice and quick to go through. Just need p importer equals iterator with the path we have. If it's not equal, null. Okay, if it's not equal null pointer, then what we want to do is go new importers dot place back with p importer. Ah, come on, Clang. One day, well, and VS Code, you guys should be doing better than this. Or I need a new editor. It doesn't like to break thanks to language servers so easily. File system. Importer base. Can break. If we get out here and p importer equals null pointer, then we need to do we can't just break out of this. We need to jump several, so we need to go to dependency found. Need to go down to the outer loop. If it's null pointer, then we failed find. That'll skip down to here and then carry on for the next dependency. Now, what's with file system? Which makes no sense because all the rest of these. What? I definitely bring in file system. I'm sorry. I just couldn't read, that's all. It's referenced, thank you. Okay, so we've got the dependencies and we've got the importers. Make sure. If we failed any, then we're out. All right. What did we do next after the iterators? We check for duplicates, perhaps. Well, we would have actually done that here. Dependencies, duplicates. Check, 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 check. Okay. If inner iterator equals star iterator. Just leave it like that for the moment. Return not false. No pointer. So then we, so that was the duplicates. That's dependency finding the importers, which is the same as this. Then we need to check. Check transitive dependencies, which means dependency iterator for dependency. No, we need this equals. How do we use this? Okay, because we're always going up to where we are right now. Okay, this is actually a bit more because it's not sharing the same list anymore. Is it? I need to have the importers up to the same point. Or So we need a P importer, which is get. Get dependencies of transitive. Okay. Let's just do it properly here. Otherwise, we pass and we're back out here. And then we come back out. We've checked the dependencies. Then set the ECS groups after that point. But first, let's see if we even make it to this point. Need to add the function that generates which we'll add to here. Call it, where do we have it? Do we even have it in here? Do we have something similar? We'll probably have to have a new function. Yeah, okay, new function then. We'll just, okay, info importer a star. This in here after the namespace, and it'll be if this state data path is a directory. If and this. And this is a regular file path. And I need to do this a couple more times. Then we'll return new foe distributed YAML importer with the state data path as a start. Dependencies that. So index data file path is directory for these two. Otherwise, return null pointer. This is the function that we add to the application, to the importer. Yeah. It's currently this. And search paths. Right now, I don't actually have anything, do I? I have some empty stuff. So I can just say, you know, Not so sure on the group ID thing anymore, actually. Ah, well, we'll leave it like that for the moment. So at least make sure we get to this point. If it even builds, that is, which it doesn't. Oh. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, we got this one. Which goes to this one. It starts this one. Goes to this one, which then goes into like that. Okay, we'll just add another directory in here. Okay, close that up and come back down to here. So it's true, we have the dependencies, we have the data, which is just one. There's no duplicates, of course. Gotta go through, this should be false, correct? Let's just have a look. Why it failed. It should be because it couldn't find the importer. But so the path is this. Okay. That's because it doesn't have a dependency file or index data, right? If I add these, does it then pass? Yeah. And then it goes to this and then leaves. So I'm going to check transitive dependencies, which we don't have yet. Okay. Okay, then now we check transitive dependencies. We do have two dependencies. Oh no, we have one dependency, but we do have a transitive, which means he should be requiring A. He can't find A, so he leaves. Which is good. But if we did, if two dependencies, okay, good. Found it. So we should always actually find it and break out. Wait, no, it only breaks out of this one, doesn't break out of the second one. So we're good at this point. Okay. So that's a good portion of the startup. Now, before I go any further, I really should get a proper error system out. Because right now, just returning true and false with a log. The log is useful, but it shouldn't be all and end all. It should have like an actual error code that it returns, perhaps. And simulation set will be a pointer to the thing that would be set. I think so. Anyways, because using this as a because this is either this is basically true or false, which is also not going to tell me much. I mean, it will basically tell you to check the error log, but it'd probably be best to have an error code that gives you some information and says please check error log for more information. Then you'll have this more detailed stuff. So I'm going to need some error codes, and then I need some tests. I need some tests to test this stuff, make sure it works correctly. Okay, I'm gonna pause this, grab a drink. Okay. Nope. Do I have? I must have error code somewhere. Here we go. Yeah, okay. Let's put these in a separate thing so we can actually get a separate files. few of them that breaks from that. So this is import state. I thought I removed that. Import state. Oh no, I just added. Okay, I thought there would be more issues, but not today. Okay, error codes. State import category. I could just do this. Okay. Simple enough. Now what we need to do is error, first error will be like, no importer, I guess. Looks like it's already, Clangdy is just not staying alive today. Like, it's not like I have 0111. I presume this is the more recent one. Yeah, that's it. From March 2nd. Okay. So let's say we return. Okay. Two, three, four. Okay, so we're back to this point. We return. Return that instead, which is success, the success case. So at this point, we've got transitive dependencies. We've got some better error codes being returned. Not quite at this point yet, but now we're going to actually start. So we need to okay. So at this point, we have, how do we do this? We want to do, we have the set of. If I could English, right? ECS include groups. This is what we have. We want to add groups. We are generating index data from each of them. Okay. We need index generator. So we need to go into, yes. So like on import, this, ECS normalized to group ID, yeah. Generator takes in the name, which is iterator, and Okay, then do we need to import index data for the subgroups? I don't think so. This has to go to the importer, basically. So go to the base. Okay. So I can actually fix that up a little bit. That's a file down. Now we need to do the same thing here. Otherwise, we need to import this. Okay, p importer, git group index data, whatever, and it's like this p simulation group or set. If not retval, error importing. Okay, this is probably a better way to describe the importing data. So then it would be like back down to the real interesting stuff, which is resource importing. And then we're basically home free again. Okay. All right, right. Import group state data. So that'll basically still be the same, except that'll be from an importer. So it'll be P simulation set state data based on the ECS group that we're working on, and then finally that. Something like that. Is there anything we need to import for resources? The answer is no. Okay, now I need to re-look at groups. That's the big interesting one right now. Path, ECS groups. I'm thinking I can build a translation layer on the fly rather than having it a permanent. Or No, I need a permanent translation layer for resources, don't I? Yeah. Okay, it's still, I need to work on groups. I need a new concept of what a group is, an ECS group. What is it specifically? It needs to be something like this. This is the group. Then we'd have a foe. Something like that. And then we'd have the index generator. Something like that. Now this is what? It's some size. I don't know what the size is anymore. Perhaps it'd be something like this. P generator. So that these can be somewhat smaller. Because we're working with pointers, basically, anyways. Okay, actually, I can tell from there. 176 bytes. Why is this so large? Probably because it has a couple other things we don't need. CNA we don't use CNAME anymore. Or do we? If I was to ex start exporting stuff, okay, I'm gonna need to take a. I'm gonna have to think on this for a little walk. I'll be back shortly. Okay, I'm thinking I'll have to create a data importers thing like this as well, then actually. So rather than rather than doing this with thumb groups and whatever, let's back that up. Oh crap, I just did the wrong file. Right, good job me. I completely whoops. Can I back this up? Okay. Don't save that. Okay, and the undeclared identifier. Really? Oh yeah. Too few calls for that. What does it need? And the simulation set. Error code can move up to here. And then we have Clang is already broken again. Nope, it seems to fix itself. Doesn't have to happen often. So that should mean I don't actually need to use this anymore. Import state from file. Reading entity stuff. Yeah, okay, let's get this stuff done at least. So, distributed YAML, we need a need to override it, and it's based on do we need resource pools here? I don't think we do. State pools, though, make sense. I may need some kind of translation mechanism, but that should be brought over. Maybe. Let's at least get this in. Nope, Clang is dead. Again, as usual, it just doesn't stay alive. Pointer of that stuff. Okay, we go back to distributed YAML. This, and then this. So how would this work? This would be on, so this is basically the first portion which does the recursive iteration. The group translations would occur internally. Iterator is going through. Okay, so this. So need to do the try and the catch in here. First of all, actually, we need to open the file. Then we've got to do the try. Okay, this is, where is it from? Entity.hpp, which was in here, so. Why do I have all this stuff? Again, remind myself. Got the group ID. Yeah, I need the group translations for this. That would make the most sense. But I don't need the resource pools. That much is for sure. Nope. Thank you. So node ID group and group translations. I need to get the group translations into here somehow. Which means what? How do we generate group translations? We had these, which is a name and a group together. Now, if we're assuming that groups are always the same, okay, actually, that's something I need to do now. Either rip out the old these guys. Okay, it'll be something like this. Yeah, we'll change it to that. Sans string names like that. Normalized source group will be 0, 1. It starts at 0. Ray starts at 0. Come on, really, Clang's already? I swear. Okay. Technically, this set of group translations is what I would want to put in the importer, isn't it? So, how's about we just add it? Would you just frickin' that, right? Something like that, okay. Translation, and we can have it as part of this. What is this? Something like group translation and end. So then I can just move around because it's just basically a standard, a vector in its heart of hearts. Which is a lot of issues associated with it right now. For that, I need to set the translation later. Okay, so that's not quite going to work as I had hoped. Okay, one thing we're going to do then, we're going to just start ripping entity, no, export and import, we can just cancel those. Don't build anymore, we don't need them. We got a whole bunch of problems to deal with. Distributed YAML, this no longer takes that. Just the root directory. We'll have to add the group translation later or figure some kind of other mechanism for adding it. But it has to be available to the importer before we're importing stuff. I need to, okay, as part of the importer base, I need to do something like like a standard move. Something like that. Group translation. Then in here we'll have that for override. Where's name? Is name not here? There it is. We'll add that back in now. Okay, let's get some things out of the way. So, stage that. Stage these. Stage that. Okay, we got that. We want to do group translations. Because where do we use group translation? This may just be something I don't want to even have up there. I'll move it somewhere else down below, I think. Because it makes more sense for it to be down there, really. Like down here. Get rid of group translation. Resource pools are gone. Too few calls. We got that. We need the groups, so undistributed YAML, we're importing what? State data for this. What is the group? What is the group I'm working on right now? That is V undefined reference to V table for faux importer base. The virtual bools. Oh. Maybe. Okay, so I need to add, once I created the groups, then I need to go back into each of the importers. Importer translations. Set group translation, and the group translation will be based on the dependencies. No, it's the iterator dependencies. Get dependencies. Oh. Okay, maybe not. Okay, we got the dependencies. We checked for duplicates. This is where we generated the importers. Check transitive dependencies. We should really do that as a separate step, yeah. Dang it. We'll do it at this point. So after ID groups, so. Move them into there. So we got the importer. So actually, when we get to this point, import state data, we're doing this. We have the entity node, we have the targeted group. Then we have NM group translation. And all I need now is the figure out the target group. Which I should also really be part of this. So is it part of... One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I'd have to give it as part of this, wouldn't I? That's what I'm thinking of anyways. Because when we build this, we can have it as part of this, for sure. Okay. So we've got errors from... yes. Yeah, an importer. This is now taking in what? Takes in that. Okay. This is taking in what? For the top level? Persistent, the top level one. Maybe I can reorder this so that the ID things are up at the top instead. And then we check if they succeed or fail. Generate translations, standard string. And groups. Oh, I didn't actually add it to be compiled. Simple mistakes. Okay, it's seemingly alive. I mean, there's nothing to actually add yet, so let's see if it just runs without failing out horribly before I add anything else of interest. Okay. Going to import state data. Now, one thing I'm going to have to do is try to figure out how to do the resource and state data import functions. I need to have this populate basically as soon as it's created. Which is going to be a bit of a fun one, I suppose. Maybe. Okay, let's actually just add like an empty state thing here. Something like that. Was it? It was position. Then we had orientation. Okay, that's annoying. Hmm. Never even reaches this. Cool. So it's airing out sometime before. Cool. Not set up group the data. Oh, because it's being set up at zero as well. So we set them up like this. Then we do have this data available now. So simulation that for a persistent group. Okay, we go in there. Here. It's not that. Successfully parsed it. Then we leave. Set that. And then away we go. So that's basically a full replacement of this, which I'll take. Let's save what we got. Refine it a little bit more. Then we'll move on to the next part. Wait, no, not yet, because I only have the list. I need to export the list of like this importer list into what? I guess right now it would just be into the simulation set. Cause that's what I wanted to do, was I wanted to get it all kind of put together. So that now I can actually get like the data importers, which is similar to groups. But I'll do that next time. I've done enough for this time. Cheers.